Hello everyone. Alright, so this video is going to be a sort of a guide on how to set up your DAISY game to run CragZ mod server with no password message. Alright, since I'm pretty crap at editing, you know, I'll do it this way. So it's going to be a raw material made into a video. If you're seeing this, you're referred on our Discord page by a friend, or you saw some YouTube videos, you know, I'm looking at you long shot. Now, to clear things a little bit, CragZ is custom modded server with custom base building and in-game trading. So, in order to play, and for all the players to have equal experience while playing and being unable to exploit a game in such a way that will advantage them and harm other player, you know, our beloved admin Scrum and his team, not sucking up in a little bit, not a little bit, created a server in such a way that you need certain files to be able to play on it. Other way, it will prompt you with the message password needed and such when you try to log on the server from the LAN section of the game. Excuse me. So, how in the hell to set it up, you ask? Good question. Glad you ask. Well, let me tell you. Assuming you're not a Steam user, but you still want to play DAISY standalone on our server, what you need to do is a few simple steps. Step 1. Get your ass to download section. It's a fourth from above. It's called download /062. And you will find there a DunkZ torrent file, which is their cracked game. We are not distributing it, we're just using it as its convenient way to apply our mods. You know, it's much simpler to do it on already cracked game than on a Steam version, which I'll explain later when we get to that point. So you get this DunkZ full installer download, which you can get also from Dunk page. It will open you in the torrent file, such a thing, you know. I already have that one, so I will not download it again. It's a pretty much 2 point something, you know, I don't know how much gigabytes, but never mind, forget it. Now, after you download it, you use their installer for installing the actual game, you know. Now, you do that, you have a game. You can play other servers from it and such a thing. Now, that's the first step. Step 2, now pay attention to this, it is important. Go to update tab on a Discord channel. There you will find a few files, but basically you need just one or two, depending on what you want, actually. First file you need is update6.rar.torrent. This one I marked over here, yeah. Now, you click it, it will download the torrent where you need to download it, right? So we'll close this. Okay. So I already downloaded and it's sitting right now, as you can see. Now you open the location where it's downloaded. So it's here. Never mind. Ignore it. Let's say we download it. If I can find it, actually. Here. Yeah. Here it is. We had unloaded our file into our folder, default folder for the torrent program. Now, you also noticed that here I have a cell trader PBL file. It is also available to download in the updates folder or a tab. This file will just give you some more options for trading on in-game traders, you know. Now, if you suffer from the poor internet connection, you know, we also have a Mediafire file right under the torrent file. This is for the slow internet connection. Now, when you download this, the important thing is before you do anything else, disable your protection, antivirus, firewall, Windows Defender, any type of thing, because it will mess up your process and you will need to start all over again. So you done that, you disable your antivirus protection, the Windows Defender, blah 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 blah. Good. Now extract files in such a way that you will have a separate folder for it. So right click on the archive, extract to update 6. It will made a separate folder like this one. See here. Now I'll hit cancel here because I already extracted here. And what you need to do, double click it and open it. Now, next thing is mark all the files, hit copy, open your game folder, if I find it, yeah, it's here, and you'll see just the dunk files without this above, of course, that's the these files. So you just copy this and paste it in here. Oh, fuck it. Let's see. Paste it in here. Now, I already have all those files, so I'll just hit cancel because I don't want to overwrite them. But in case you don't have them, just copy, paste. Simple as that. And you're done with that shit. Now, for that cell trader PBO, you don't actually open it. Forget it. You open the add-ons folder in your game directory. And then use same thing. Copy paste. I also already have that one, so I'll hit cancel, but you'll hit move and replace file, whatever. Now, you're done with that too. Your game is now set up. Next thing, what you need to do, of course, after you close all this shit, go back, find the Crexy launcher. Now you go to properties. Here it will be located. Unblock. Hit that. Hit apply. Hit OK. Next thing you need to do, open your antivirus protection. Depending on which type you use, I, for example, use this one. It was free, so I don't give a shit. Go to your settings, go to general, go to exception. Now, since you did disable it before you extracted your files. Now you need to first enable it. Excuse me. Now, you go to exception, make a path to the exception file of your game. Now, this is important because the way game is modded, it's basically crack, you know. You know what crack is. It's a sort of a code that tricks the game to think it's a full version, basically. Now, that thing is not very liked with protection, you know. So, you need to make a exception file, a path, sorry, for the game, so your antivirus don't get fucked up and screw up your game. If you don't do this shit, it will stop your game from working. And you need to do all this all over again. Now, you finish that. You see, I already have that one for every file, you know, just in case. Finish that. Open your game folder. Here it is. Find the CrackZ Launcher 2 file.exe. Right click on it, run as administrator. Always do this first time you mod the game. Every time the Scrum posts a new update file, you do the same copy paste. You need to run the CrackZ Launcher as administrator. Why? Because you give it a right to run prior to the firewall protection. Basically, it's avoiding the firewall protection, you know. You as administrator are allowing it to connect the game to the internet. Sorry, internet. Now, hit run as administrator, it will open the launcher. You need this launcher in order to play the game. You cannot access it from the LAN section of the game even after you done all this fuckery with it. Why? Because this is dedicated to the CrackZ server only. Right now you see server 1 and Sanchez. You might not see Sanchez in future updates, never mind. Maybe it's been replaced with PvP, who knows. For right now, the server 1 is the main server you will need to enter. Choose the server 1 as the default, hit connect. It will launch the game in a few moments, maybe start coughing up, you know, a little bit, depends on how good your machine is, maybe not, who knows. You will be able to play the game after you exit the game. You need to enter it by this launcher again. Now this time you don't need to run it as administrator because you already done it before. Also, you already made the exception file path in the antivirus protection. So you just next time make the shortcut somewhere, you know, I don't know, I have a quick launch here. Basically hit the icon, open up, hit connect, simple as that. Now, for the Steam users, as far as I know, you need to open your Steam library folder. I don't know, do I have one? I think I do. Let me see. No, I don't. No, I don't. Never mind. So, you open up the Steam folder, find the game directory, made a copy of that folder to a separate one, you know, find some location, for example, I don't know, made a new folder CrackZ62, bam, paste. I don't want to do that shit. I don't want to mess up my game. But that's basically what you do. You know. Hit, copy, paste. Now, after you paste your base game Steam game folder to that location. Then you open it and apply the mod the same way I described for the Dank Daisy game. I think I made it clear enough.